Hello and welcome to NewsClick. Today we are going to discuss about the disability bill that has been recently passed in the parliament. To discuss the issue, we have with us Muralidharan, who is secretary of National Platform for Rights of Disabled. So welcome to NewsClick.
Thank you.
This bill has been passed in the parliament and it has been result of a long struggle that has been carried out by different disability rights organizations, activists. So what are the provisions of this bill? And how is it going to benefit people?
Bill is actually in compliance to a convention that India has signed actually. It's called United Nations Convention on Rights of Persons with Disabilities. The UNCRPD mandates, once you sign a international convention, UN convention, it is mandatory, it is obligatory on any signing country to harmonize its law in accordance with the convention that we have signed. It is to comply with this international obligation that this law has actually been drafted and brought forward. So India was one of the first countries to actually sign and ratify this treaty.
Which year?
2007 actually. But it actually took now nearly... Almost a decade to actually get a law passed in the country. This actually process began in 2009 actually. But 2012, a draft bill was brought about, there were problems with the draft and all that. 2014, actually, February, the first bill was introduced in the Rajya Sabha, actually. Actually, UPA government was on its way out at that time when the bill was introduced. There were several issues with the bill, several concerns about the bill, and we were not in total agreement with the bill. So we had asked at that time, we had demanded rather at that time, that this bill should not be passed in this form, and it should be sent to a parliamentary standing committee. And the demand actually, though we had raised it from outside, it was supported. Sitaram Yechury from the CPM actually had raised this issue in the Lok Sabha and had demanded that it be sent to the standing committee. The chair agreed and it was sent to the standing committee. But May 2015, the standing committee submitted its report to the new government. From May 2015 actually, we have been demanding from the government that they bring in amendments or an action taken report based on the recommendation made by the standing committee and the concerns expressed by YAT. So again, this August at our central executive meeting, we had decided that we should, unless we exert more pressure on the government, nothing is going to happen. So again, we started a campaign, began a signature campaign, then had state-level demonstrations and mobilizations. Again, it culminated in a rally in Jantar Mantar, again, this year also. December 3 is actually celebrated as International Day of Persons with Disabilities. But we were not celebrating either last year or this year. But this year actually, but before December 3 actually, December 2, we came to know that the actually, a day before that, the government had announced through a PIB release that the Union Cabinet has finalized certain amendments and is going to move it on December 2. So we are cautious on December 3 because what the government is going to bring, we don't know. Though some announcements had been made, some of them were actually positive in nature. Positive in the nature in the sense that some of our concerns were addressed in the amendments that the government was going to bring about. Negative in the nature because some of the progressive things that were spelt out, there were part of the 2014 bill were diluted. What are the positive aspects, if you ask me, I would say, there was no definition about discrimination in the bill.
Oh.
What constitutes discrimination on the grounds of disability was not part of the bill. That has actually been introduced as an amendment. This was one of our demands that we had raised. And also the definition as far as what constitutes disability has also been a bit more widened now as compared to the original bill. This is one. And there are more in the sense that, sign language has been recognized and the communication business, video and audio, those things have been recognized now. So there is captioning, TV captioning has been made mandatory now. Sign language thing has been made mandatory now. So all these things were not part of the original bill, which have come in the form of amendments now, which are welcome. But at the same time, There are two major concerns that we had actually talked about that. This clause 3.3, which says that a person with disability can be discriminated against if there is a legitimate ground for that. If it is to achieve a legitimate aim. We had said this is an anti-discriminatory legislation. You can't have a clause which legitimizes discrimination.
Exactly.
This was one of our main contention or main concerns against the bill, for which we said this cannot be passed in this form as it is. This amendment that the government had brought, official amendment that came to this bill, did not address that concern adequately. Instead of appropriate means, they said it is proportional means. Actually, it does not alter the formulation in any substantive manner. So we asked we stuck to our this thing that this should be deleted. This is where CPM MPs have actually helped us in Parliament also. They moved specific amendments asking for the deletion of this clause on our request. Minister Sitaram Yechuri had raised it, K.K. Ragesh and C.P. Narayan had moved specific amendments for deletion of this clause. On the basis of the discussion, on the basis of this amendment, the minister, while replying to the discussion, said that he will see to it that the rules are being framed, this thing will be taken care of, and it will be so done that it would not be to the disadvantage of the disabled. That was a good assurance that was given to the Parliament. And when the chair also said that a minister cannot go back on his assurance, that was one of the good things. The second concern we had, one of the more major concerns we had, was about employment section. Actually, the employment, currently there is a reservation of 3% as per the 1995 Act. But their provision, original bill had a provision for 5%. It has been reduced now. Through amendments, this percentage of reservations has been reduced to 4%. The number of disabilities that are covered have risen from 7 to 21 now.
Okay.
So 14 new disabilities have been added.
While the criteria for reservation has been reduced.
Percentage of the reservation has been reduced. I'm not saying that all of them are going to get reservation. No. All of them are not going to get reservation. But even other ways, the scope has been widened. So you need to have a proportionally higher number of percentage to address this issue. Instead of doing that, what you've done, you've just added 1% to it, which is reduced 1% from the existing 5% that has been proposed by this thing. Existing is 3%, what was proposed was 5%, now it has been reduced to 4%. This is one thing. But second thing is, much more dangerous thing what we felt out, is there is a provision which says that this would be in post meant to be filled by persons with disabilities. You see, the earlier existing Act also, 95 Act, there was a provision which was misinterpreted by enforcement agency, by government, at various state governments, to see that reservations are given to disabled persons only in posts that are identified for them. See, disabled are not employed, reservations are not against all posts. All posts are not open for persons with disabilities.
Oh, okay.
There are categories or posts that are identified in which disabled people are recruited. So once you say identified, it will be only on those posts they are given.
So it's also a more limited scope in that.
Yes, yes. It is open to misinterpretation. So we had said this clause that meant to be reserved for persons with disabilities should be deleted. The same again, CPM MPs had moved the same amendment, and our minister has given an assurance on that also, so to see that rules are framed in such a manner that that misinterpretation is not there.
The government signed the UN Convention in 2007. Was there no bill at all before 2007, or there were such similar bills, or the Bill of 95 which proposed reservation? So, I mean, can you throw some light on that?
Both internationally and in our country as well are the most marginalized sections of society. India especially. And of course, in the West, in Europe, etc., you can find disabled moving around city like others, like other humans actually, because through wheelchairs. It's much more accessible in the West. In our country, it's not that much. Accessibility is still being discussed now.
Leave aside the implementation.
Implementation is still being discussed now. Now you have the government coming up with an Accessible India campaign a lot. Now they are actually, and it's focused also on major cities. Cities like Delhi or metros and other cities. We're not talking about going to the rural areas where much of the disabled population lives. That's a different issue, but still, I'm just trying to. So, 48 years after independence only, you had a law.
Right.
Until 1995, you had no law that would address some concerns of disabled. Of course, you had the Rehabilitation Council of India Act, or there are actually four legislations that govern the disabled of the country. 1995 only this act came into being. So before that, there was no talk of disability anywhere. This has also come about because of some international pressure, some local movement building up and all that. See, if you talk about the constitution, in the constitution there are Article 15(1) and Article 16(2) talk about grounds on which discrimination is prohibited. Prohibited grounds of discrimination. Discrimination is prohibited on the grounds of caste, on the grounds of religion, on the grounds of language, on the grounds of sex, various other things. But disability is not talked about in those. So we have been from the right since our inception, what we have been talking about is this should be an amendment that should be moved to the constitution to make discrimination on the grounds of disability also prohibited.
You've talked about continuously how the Member of Parliament from the left organization, specifically CPM, have contributed in pushing this bill in the Parliament. But has there been involvement of any other political organization in your entire movement?
See, disability, as I said, disability is still, I said, people are marginalized. This is not an issue for most of the mainstream political parties. The left, especially the CPM, has been taking up the issue in a serious and a concerted manner. I would like to talk to you. So last three party congresses of CPM actually have adopted resolutions on one issue or the other of talking about disability. No other political party has actually talked about disability as such. If you go through the discussion in the Raj Sabha, you will find actually both the ruling party and the Congress were for passing of the bill without any discussion. They didn't want to move amendments either in the Raj Sabha. There were actually all the amendments, major amendments or substantive amendments were moved by CPM MPs. The Congress of Subramanian Reddy made some amendments which were which he didn't move also. He didn't press for moving those amendments also. He just mentioned, but that were not substantive in nature as far as my reading goes. So left has been serious about this issue, as it has been about other social issues as well.
If we talk about your organization, National Platform for Rights of Disabled, when was it formed? Can you throw some light on what was the need to bring this organization and how did it develop?
We felt the need actually. There is a huge gap in terms of movement as far as disabled are concerned. There are thousands of organizations working in the country among disabled. Small organizations, most of them do actually service delivery. Some do advocacy also, but there are NGOs actually, not doing service delivery and advocacy also some of them doing. But they are not membership-based organizations. They do not actually represent the whole movement as such. Some are specific disability, like for the blind, like for the deaf, or like that. And they are not cross-disability. There are cross-disability organizations also, but they are small in terms of membership or the mobilization capacity is concerned. So there was a huge gap at the national level to do advocacy and to bring pressure on the government to change and do policy interventions also. We needed to fill that gap and to also take this movement in a right direction. Actually, we need to give a policy direction, a right direction to this movement. So we felt the need. We came together at a convention in Calcutta in 2010. We formed a representation from 10 states scheme, and then we formed this platform at the national level. Out of the formation of the platform at this national level, we started building units in the states, in many of the states. Now we have units in 14 different states, And many of them who are not associated with us, have no link with us or our movements, are now wanting to become affiliates of this platform or applying for become affiliates of this platform.
So with one step achieved, what's the way forward? What are your next plans? And I mean, what's the way ahead to take this entire bill so that, I mean, I've read the press statements, so that the promises made are actually implemented on the ground?
First thing will be to see whether the other concerns can be addressed or not. The assurance that the minister has given in parliament to the MPs, we would like to see that those are actually, whatever manner it comes in the rules he has said. So we will have to keep a watch on how the rules are framed. Second thing is, implementation is going to be a huge task. Even this 95 Act, only with 7 disabilities, one of the major things that we have been actually raising is about certification. The certificate is a basic document for any entitlement that disabled has to get.
Exactly.
But we dispute the census figures. We say it has not been a right counting. Even if you go by the UN standards or WHO standards, it has not been a right counting. It is an undercounting. Even if you say that, take the 2011 census as a correct figure, even by those standards, what the ministry says, the annual report of 15-16, Ministry of Social Justice, Department of Disabled Affairs says that only 49.5% of disabled population identified by the 2011 census have been issued certificate. So the majority of the disabled population, or if you say 50% of the disabled population, do not possess certificates. So all entitlements, whether it be in the field of education, employment, or other concessions like rail travel or whatever the government has given, any schemes, he is not entitled to. He cannot even file a case under the Act unless he has a certificate. So all these things he is deprived of. Now you have a huge task. From 7 disabilities, you have increased to 21. Who is going to certify them?
Thanks a lot for giving us your time, and as things proceed, we'll be coming back to you on such issues. Thank you for watching NewsClick.